Hi, welcome to a problem solving video by Robojax. In this video, we are going to see how we can fix the 16 channel 5 volts relay module for Arduino that is receiving incorrect voltage from the input. As you can see, I fixed this now. Input is 15 volts and the regulated voltage for these relays are 5 volts and they are working very normally with the rated voltage. Let's get started with this. A video explaining how to use this relay module, but the problem, there's a big problem with this module, is that the relays that are used are 5 volts and they are sold as 5 volts relay module, but the voltage regulator that is here, the design has a flaw and the regulated voltage does not reach these. Whatever voltage you have, let's say you have 9 volts, 12 volts, whatever voltage you have will be regulated to 5 volts and the 5 volts will be supplied to this optocoupler, but the relays will receive whatever voltage you have at input. If you are supplying 5 volts, that is fine and you will get a little less than 5 volts to the relay, that will be no issue. But you want to have a regulated voltage for these supplies. For example, if you connect 9, 12, 15 volts, even up to 25 or 30 volts, they should receive only 5 volts. And I'm going to fix it and show you in this video how to take care of that. Supplying or connecting these relay to the voltage higher than 5 volts will be very dangerous if you're having a real application device or connected to this. Soon these relays will die because they will not be able to handle continuous higher rated voltage. With the voltage, there is a voltage regulator. I've connected it to external power supply and let's say the input voltage, as you can see, is 5 volts and that is the input, and I'm putting my probe and read the voltage. So I'm reading the input voltage, 5 volts on my multimeter, and the voltage on the relay is of course the same. Now let me increase the voltage. Now it's around 8.72 volts. Regulated voltage is 5 volts, as you can see. So this chip is regulated at 5 volts. All relays are driven by these transistor arrays, and this is the pin that shows a common pin. We have ULN2803, so the common pin is on this side. The voltage from voltage regulator comes to this, and each relay is driven by this. So 8 of them by this, and 8 of these 8 relay will be driven by this. Now if I check this, this chip is receiving 8.7 volts. So exact same voltage is coming here, and then this will supply the voltage to the relay. Only I've turned on one of the relay. So if I check the voltage across the two pin of the relay, you will see that we are reading 7.75 volts. The other relay is off and we are not reading any voltage. Only this one is on, and also here, that's the voltage including the resistor and diode, 7.78 volts. And that is concerning. This is a very, very bad design that allows the whole voltage to come here. This is the schematic diagram that I have just drawn. And this is the corrected version, because the output voltage from the regulator, the 5 volts, have been connected directly to the relay and the common pin of this transistor array chip. This schematic diagram will be also provided. The device has this LM2596 3 ampere converter. This is the module. Pin 2 is an output, pin 1 is the input. This pin 1 is the input, pin 2 is the output, this is the regulator. The 5 volts from the regulator is just feeding to these optocouplers. It's not connected to this. Now in order to fix this and make sure that these receive 5 volts, I will have to rearrange and rewire it. After testing and tracing all the tracks, I realized that this is just supplying 5 volts to these optocoupler. If I check this, for example, the pin 2 continuity tester shows that only these are being supplied with 5 volts. Now I'm gonna cut this direct power to this chips and wire it with the 5 volts from here to here. The positive is coming from here, passing through that path that you see underneath of this capacitor to the plus, and that is the minus side. And from here it comes to the pin 1, and from here you see the small pass-through hole. It's coming on this side. It's coming on this side to this point, and from here it goes to the one pin of this chip, and from here we have another path that goes here and feeds this chip as well. So two of them are fed from the other side. Now if I cut this path here, this chip will not receive voltage, so I can rearrange it. I'm just getting a knife. Let me test it again. Now it's disconnected. Now let's check the input and this chip. It is not connected. That's good. Now I'm going to, this point is connected to pin 2, as you can see. Now I have connected the power. If I connect it across the Schottky diode, I will get 5 volts, even though at the input, you can see where I'm getting 8.7 volts. Output doesn't have any voltage, 0.6 volts. That is because of the diode. These two doesn't have any voltage now. As you can see, the winding of the relay is these two. This line, this wire, and this one is connected. This is also connected to this relay because the relays have been flipped on the other side. Now I've connected a wire from this point that I showed you initially, which is connected to pin 2, and this wire is going from the hole that is already there. I didn't do anything, it just passed through, and I soldered it at this pin of relay. These are all common voltage for the relay, and this is each control. Now after soldering the wire, let's check the voltage. We have 8.6 volts, and at this point we have exactly 5 volts. And if I flip it on this side, that is a common, the wire that I have. This has 5 volts, and the other relay also has 5 volts. All of them will have, even this side will have 5 volts. And so this will be controlled by the relay. The ground will be on this side, and that will be fine. And here I'm testing it with input voltage of 15 volts. The regulated voltage is 5 volts to the relay. And as you can see, it's perfectly running. Let me show you also the voltage of this wire. We see exactly 5 volts. Thank you for watching. This was how to fix the problem of the voltage regulation for the 16 channel module. If you like this video, please thumb up, and also subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos.